Where's that email? Where's the spreadsheet? Did you ever try to find something and you type the name exactly as it is and nothing? You use the little search command in your email and you put someone's name in it. You do it 10 ways from Sunday, still nothing. I'm gonna show you how to master the find command, which is also called Spotlight on your Mac, so that you can never lose anything again and be a wizard of the search. So I'll show you the quick version to easily find your stuff first, and then in the second part, I'll get into a little more detail so you can understand better and get exactly the results you want. So we're gonna start with mail and doing a basic search in there. Let's say there was a nice pool float that you saw in one of your favorite newsletters. So you would type up in the search box here, from:SwissMiss, which is the newsletter. And you want to ignore the little drop-down menu. I'll talk about that later in the video. You press return on the keyboard. Then you type pool float. And it's not coming up with anything. You want to also choose where you're searching in this nearly invisible little gray bar here where it says search, and that's because I'm in the sent folder. So if you click all, then that message will come up and you can click on it, and the amazing rainbow pool float is right there. Let's say that you want to find an invoice that you got from an awesome Macinhome consultant sometime in July. You would go up to the search box, and you would type from:Aaron and press return. And then you would type subject:invoice and press return. And then you type the word July and press return. And so now you're gonna see all of the messages, the emails that you got from Aaron in July. And there is a little difference here between searching for the subject or searching in the entire message. And you can click this tiny little arrow here and say, I want to search the entire message for the word invoice. So it's not just searching in the subject. And then let's say that this is the one that you want. You can open it and do what you need. Now let's say you want to find an Excel document on your Mac that you had looked at in July, and it's somewhere in your Mac and you don't know where it went. You would go into a Finder window here by clicking on the Finder face. In the little search box, you type the word Excel. And you'll notice in the drop-down, you get the choice of the Excel document here. So you can do the arrow key down to Excel and hit return. And then you want to change to list view from this little button here, make the window a little bigger. And you want to notice where you're searching, because you could be searching on the desktop or you could be searching in the whole Mac. And in this case, I want to search in the whole Mac. And then if I go under date last opened and look at the date, this is the one here that I'm looking for. It was opened in July, and it's an Excel document. It'll even show you where it is on the little path bar across the bottom here. And now let's say you want to find a keynote pitch somewhere in your documents folder. So if you go into your documents folder, and then up in the top right here, you type keynote. And again, you do the arrow keys down to keynote document. And then if you type the word pitch, it will search for that as well and just press the return key there. And if you type or if you click on the documents folder here, it'll search only within the documents. And there's the one that I needed. And now for the second part of this video, these are the top six things that you'll want to know in order to really have it under your control and get the results that you want with the search and find. First and foremost, you want to control where you're searching. If you don't want to search all over everywhere and get way too many results, it'll help to first go to the right starting place. So like if I want to search in my documents folder, I would click on the Finder, and then I would click documents, and then up here I would type Excel, hit the arrow key down a couple of times to choose the kind Excel document, and then I can click here to search within documents. I still have the option of searching anywhere on this Mac. In mail, if I first go to the sent folder to search in there, and then I want to find emails to James, then I have the choice here to search between all mail or just in the sent folder. So it helps a lot to know where you are. And next you want to choose what type of thing it is that you're searching for. So if I go into the Finder and I type the word keynote, and it's searching anywhere on this Mac, then you're going to get anything on your Mac that has the word keynote anywhere in it, which can be overwhelming depending on what you're searching for. If you search for keynote and then choose the kind of keynote document, then you're going to get only keynote documents. And if you search for keynote and the name matches keynote, then you're going to get the one and only thing that matches the name keynote, which is the application itself. In Mail, same thing here, if you type Andre, just the text Andre, and you search for all, it's going to show you every single instance of the word Andre in any email anywhere in Mail. If you type 2:Andre, then it's going to show any emails that are to Andre anywhere in your email. And if you drag this little, or grab this little drop down here and choose from Andre, it'll show you any email from him. So you can choose different types of search. Next, you can look at combining multiple search filters. So if you know that you had a good chicken recipe as a PDF, then you can open a Finder window and you can type PDF, and the kind is a PDF document, and you want to search anywhere on this Mac. And then you can type the word chicken and hit return, and it's going to find any PDF that has the word chicken anywhere in it. So you can have multiple search terms. And if you go into Mail, you'll get different results if you say Aaron invoice versus saying from colon Aaron, and then you hit return, and then you say PDF, and then it has an attachment of a PDF document, and then you put the word invoice in it, and you hit return. Then you're going to get all of the invoices from Aaron that have a PDF attachment in it. And you could even say July, and it'll show you all the ones that are in July. The next tip is about natural language search. This is the search of the future, and I think we're almost there. It's not perfect yet, which is why I wanted to show you the more manual way first to make sure that you find your stuff. You can use Siri-type commands in your own words, which Mail calls natural language, but it still needs to fit a formula. So you could say, like, from Aaron, and you could say to Aaron. You could say from Aaron yesterday, and there's nothing there. You could say from Aaron in July, and you could say to Andre about hotspot. That's the hotspot video that I did. You could say flagged emails. So there's some patterns, as you can see, and you can just use regular language. I would just experiment with that and find the things that actually get the results that you want. For tip number 5, I'm going to show you some sweet keyboard commands and shortcuts. In the Finder, if you want to do a search, it is Command F, F as in find. If you go into Mail, and if you do Command F in Mail, it's going to search within an email message. So this would work if I wanted to search for that pool float thing. It opens this tiny little search box within the message here, and then you can hit done when you're done with that. But to get up into the search box in the top right, it's Command Option F, and then you can type up there. To get into Spotlight, it's Command Space. Now, I didn't talk a lot about Spotlight, just because it's more automatic and with less control, but you can often find what you want really quickly. So if I just typed chicken PDF, then it comes up really quickly, and you can do the arrow keys to choose what you want. If you press return, it'll open the thing. But if you go back into Command Space for Spotlight, find the thing that you want, and then press Command Return, it'll actually reveal it in the enclosing folder on your computer, which is amazing. When you do find the thing, where the heck was it? In Mail, once you've done your search up in the top right here, In the messages, you'll see in tiny little text where that email is. This one's in the inbox, and this one's in the all mail folder. If I do the spotlight search for my chicken PDF, and then you use the arrow keys and you press Command Return to reveal that item. If you want to know where this is and where this folder is, you just go under the View menu, and then you show the path bar, which is amazing. It shows you where you are, and it shows you where this document is. And if you have a Finder search where you're looking for an Excel document, and you found that one from July in your list here, you just click on the one that you want and press Command-R, and it will reveal where that one is, and also will have the path bar because you turned that on earlier, so you'll know exactly where it is. Boom! Mac Epiphany. Hopefully you found this helpful. If you want someone awesome and totally not condescending to come to you and take all of your technology challenges off your mind, head to macinhome.com, because you've got way better things to do with your time.
Where's that document? What are you doing? You're in my shot.
Can you yell that again?
Where's my document?